The 4222 is one of those formations that are really meta in game, and to be fair, it's one of the most meta formations to use in EAFC 24. Well balanced, absolutely great on the defense and on the attack. Not only that, also absolutely fantastic for counter attacks. You have got your right attack mid and left attack mid playing as wingers in game. So on this video, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to show you my best custom tactics to use with the 4222 after the latest patch. I have already done a video on the 4222, but this video coming after the latest patch. And to be honest, I have made some changes on the player instructions. Not only that, also on the custom tactics with the 4222. If you know me, you know it's my favorite formation. I'm always using this formation on Foot Champs. Not only that, also in Division Rivals. Right now, I'm in Division 1. So after I show you the custom tactics and player instructions, we're gonna jump into a match in Division 1 so I can explain these custom tactics for you in game. With that being said, ladies and gentlemen, before we jump into the video, if you're not around here, don't forget to subscribe. Drop a like on this video, that will be always appreciated. And if you are looking to buy FC24 coins, check out U7Buy for the cheapest prices out there. Fast delivery, safe, and use the code Y5K to get yourself up to 6% off. Link in the description. And now let's jump straight into the video, starting things up with defensive style. Of course, I'm going with balance. Like I always say, don't start the match with press after possession lost or pressure on heavy touch, because it can easily cost you a goal from a counter attack even if you are on the start of the match. Always start the match with balance, and if you are losing, you can switch it to press after possession loss, which is absolutely great with the 4222 because you have got your right attacking mid, left attacking mid, and two center defending mids that can get you the ball quick after you lose it. Width, I'm going for 45, and depth, I'm going for 71. If I'm being honest, I'm not sure what to use for depth on all gen. For me, I play on BS5, I'm always using 71 depth with any formation that I use. So for all gen, if I'm being honest, I'm not really sure if 71 depth works on all gen. If it doesn't, just go from something between 60 to 70 for depth. Build up play, I'm going with balance, and for chance creating, I'm going with direct passing. There's no problem if you want to go with balance for chance creating. Balance is actually really good to use in EAFC 24. But for more creativity on the attack, I'm going for direct passing. Especially with the 4222, you have got a right attacking mid, left attacking mid, and two strikers, so it would be better to use direct passing. Within the attack, I'm going for 45 plays in the box, I'm going for 6 corners and free kicks. For me, I like to go with 2. With that being said, ladies and gentlemen, this is the custom tactics. Let's move on into the player instructions. Starting things up with the defense, right center back, left center back, don't change anything with them. They both should stay back while attacking. Goalkeeper instructions, I don't change anything with my goalkeeper instructions. If you do, there's no problem at all. And for the right back and left back, they both also should stay back while attacking. No overlap, and you already have your right attacking mid and left attacking mid on the attack playing like wingers, so your fullbacks won't help you on the attack that much. Let's move on into the middle fielders and start things up with the center defending mids. Now one of them is gonna play like a proper CDM in game, and the other one is gonna be a box to box middle fielder, which means he will help you on the attack and help you on the defense at the same time. For me, what I'm going for, my left center defending mid, who is going to be a proper center defending mid in game. A player that won't help me on the attack, he will always stay back while attacking, and most of the times you're gonna see him tackling and intercepting, you won't see him on the attack at all. For me, I'm going with Tonali, absolutely great player who has got high defending work rate, and it would be better to use a player that has got the high defending work rate. For his instructions, stay back while attacking, not only that, also with cover center. For the right center defending mid, like I said, right here you need a box-to-box middle fielder. A player that you're gonna see on the attack and you're gonna see on the defense at the same time. I'm using Kevin De Bruyne, and he's absolutely great as a box-to-box middle fielder. For his instructions, cover center only, nothing else. Let's move on into the center attacking mid. You have a right attacking mid and left attacking mid. And let me be clear, they're gonna be wingers in game. You're gonna see them always trying to get in behind and playing as a right wing and a left wing in game. So make sure you are using players who has got absolutely great pace in game, because you really need that. For the instructions, come back on defense and get into the box for cross. Come back on defense is really important to use with your right attacking mid and left attacking mid, because you cannot defend while you have got 4 players up front. You need your right attacking mid and left attacking mid to come back on defense, and it will turn into a 4-4-2 formation on the defense, which is absolutely fantastic for the defense. Let's move on into the strikers. We have got a right striker and a left striker. Now one of them is gonna be the main striker, and the other one is gonna play like a center forward in game. What I mean about that is, for my right striker, he's gonna play like a center forward slash center attacking mid in game. He's gonna be the player to assess the right attacking mid, left attacking mid, or maybe the left striker. And for my left striker, I call him the main striker, because you'll always try him to get in behind and he is always there to finish the goals. All he's gonna do is get in behind the defense and finish. So for the right striker, make sure you are using a player that has got good dribbling and passing, of course with good pace and shooting, because sometimes you're gonna see him also trying to get in behind, but most of the times you're gonna see him coming back, asking for the ball and deliver it to your left striker. And for the left striker, like I said, he will always try to get in behind and break the defense line. So you need a player that has got absolutely great pace and of course with absolutely amazing finishing as well. Mo Salah, probably the best striker I have used so far in EAFC 24, and especially because he has got the finished shot play style plus. With that being said, ladies and gentlemen, this is all the player instructions and the custom tactics that I'm using with the 4-2-2. Now let's jump into a match on Division 1 and let me explain these custom tactics for you in game. We're gonna be playing against Thibaut Courtois in goal, Van Dijk, King, Vini, Griezmann and Evolution Llorente. Great by KDB. That's what I meant about the box-to-box midfielder, Kevin De Bruyne on the defense. Son trying to get in behind Salah with the through pass. Let's get back to Salah. Cutting inside with the finish, but Thibaut Courtois is there. Great interception by Virgil. Kevin De Bruyne with the ball. Come on with the through pass to Al Wairan. My man is not playing. He thought that was offside. Joe Cole with the finish. He thought that was offside. Tonali with the tackle. And Van Dijk now with the ball. With the pass to Kyle Walker. Come on, get in behind Al Wairan. Walker now with the ball. As you can see, Joe Cole, my right striker, coming back and asking for the ball. Come on with the controlled sprint. And now with an outside foot shot. That was absolutely great by Joe Cole. Theo. Nope. That's Kyle Walker with the interception. Joe Cole with the ball with the controlled sprint. If I'm being honest, he is one of the best. Look at his dribbling. He is one of the best. That's a penalty. He is one of the best players I have used in terms of dribbling. Come on, let's give him the penalty to Joe Cole. He deserves it. Down. In the middle, absolutely great. Come on, Theo. Rashford with the power shot. That was some poor defending from me. Come on, son. To Tonali, no. Kevin De Bruyne with the interception. Son with the ball, Joe Cole. Salah is available. With the pass, absolutely fantastic. Tiki Taka with the 4-2-2. Thank you, my friend. Going for a counter-attack, Son, with the base, with the Berber turn. Salah is trying to get in behind. Come on, Salah. This is your game. Come on with the ball roll. Cutting inside. Lemty. Great tackle that is by Varane. Playing it to Son. Great base by him. Salah is available. Come on, with the pass. That's Joe Cole. With the pass again, it got intercepted and that's the match done. With that being said, ladies and gentlemen, this was the gameplay with the 4-2-2. Like I said, your right attacking mid and left attacking mid gonna be a right wing and a left wing in game, and you saw that on the gameplay. While you have got your right center defending mid playing as a box-to-box midfielder, you saw Kevin De Bruyne assisting, scoring, and at the same time defending and intercepting. And of course you have got your right striker playing as a center forward slash center attacking mid. Sometimes you're gonna see him coming back and asking for the ball. So make sure you are using a player that has got absolutely great passing and dribbling. With that being said, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you enjoyed the video. Try these custom tactics and let me know how it goes for you on the comments below. I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and I will see you all in the next video. Peace.